Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I'm pleased to be here to draw attention to an important health issue that can often go unaddressed because of the stigma surrounding it. House Resolution 205 recognizes April the 10th, 2017 as National Youth HIV and AIDS Awareness Day. Young people throughout the United States are disproportionately affected by HIV. In 2015, young people ages 13 to 24 accounted for 22% of new HIV diagnoses, according to the Center for Disease Control. And young people with HIV are the least likely of any age group to be linked to care. The CDC says prevention challenges include low rates of HIV testing, inadequate sex education, and the stigma around HIV that makes young people uncomfortable with discussing their status. Nationwide, there are many agencies that are working to tackle both HIV and AIDS on several fronts, including by reducing the number of infections among our youth. And our young people, they have to step up too, because the American Psychological Association says that youth voices and peer-to-peer education are potent weapons in this fight. With that in mind, National Youth HIV and AIDS Awareness Day also highlights the contributions that young people are making in this fight against HIV and AIDS. Last week, Representative Harris and I participated in the hookup, which was sponsored by the Philadelphia Department of Human Services, and it was held right in my district in Southwest Philadelphia at the Common Place. The Department of Human Services collaborated with Turning Points for Children, the Black Gold Project, and YoACAP to sponsor the National HIV Campaign for Youth. The purpose was to provide information for teenagers from the ages of 13 to 18 and for young adults aged 19 to 24 to help them in making good decisions about risks in engaging in sexual activity and different behaviors that will expose them to the sexually transmitted infections and also to HIV. The Philadelphia Department of Public Health declared a crisis in the numbers of sexually transmitted infections among adolescent youth. The most recent study for Philadelphia found that 75% of sexually transmitted infections were among African American young people who are between the ages of 13 and 24. Sadly, this same demographic represents 25% of all newly diagnosed HIV cases. The time is now. We need family members, we need parents, we need friends, we need guardians, we need places of worship to have the hard conversations with our young people. We don't have any time to waste. We have to dispel the myths and the lies that certain forms of media tell these children, and we have to be honest with them as early as possible to ensure that they have health and that they have wellness and that they can live the life that they dreamed about and achieving all of their different dreams. I applaud all of those who are stepping up and working to combat this disease, and I hope this resolution encourages more to join them. Thank you to each and every one of my colleagues here in the House for your support on this very important issue. Thank you.